Hello, dog. Are you ready for a story? This story is all about a very, very good dog, just like you. Once upon a time, there was a dog called Stanley. He was a very special dog, as brave as a lion, loyal and kind, with a smooth, shiny coat and velvety ears that pricked up when they heard their person's voice. Not only was Stanley as brave as a lion, he was as big as a lion, too. His size made Stanley different and special, and his person loved him for it. When Stanley was first brought home, he was just a little ball of dark fur with huge, floppy paws. Now he towered over the dogs on his street and slept with his long legs flopping out of his bed. Stanley looked so enormous that when his person took him to the field at the bottom of the lane for his walk, the other dogs who were playing there would hurry away. They thought Stanley was far too big to play chase with them or sniff and snuffle around in the autumn leaves. Stanley loved his person very much, but he felt lonely. He longed for other doggy friends to run and play with and share adventures. He would pad down to the gate at the bottom of his garden, look out at the street with his big dark eyes, and wish for a friend. One afternoon, as the autumn leaves were steadily falling, Stanley strode down to the garden gate again. It was the last day before winter, and Stanley could smell it in the air. As he watched, a scruffy little pup came bounding down the street. He had curly, toffee-coloured fur, caramel eyes, and a little pink tongue. Stanley had never seen him before. "Teddy," called his owner, from farther down the street. But Teddy had caught Stanley's scent in the chilly air and decided to follow it. He bounced playfully along, then stopped and spotted Stanley's long, dark face through the slatted gate. Teddy didn't feel frightened, and he didn't hurry away, because as every good dog knows, they're wonderful at playing and sniffing and burying bones. But what dogs are very best at is being extremely good friends. Before his person could catch up with him, Teddy had sat down by the gate. He slid onto his tummy, pushed his little face through the wooden slats, and gently touched Stanley's great black nose with his. Stanley's huge tail began to wag in big, gleeful sweeps. He knew he'd found his friend. From then on, every evening, when Teddy was taken out for his walk and passed by Stanley's gate, he would push his nose through to say hello. The other dogs began to notice, and soon Stanley had many more noses pushing through the gate and friends to play chase with in the field. On winter's nights, when Stanley fell into a long, deep, doggy sleep, he dreamt of all his favourite things, of wintry walks in the woods, of curling up by a crackling fire, of biscuits for being a good boy, and meeting his new friends to play in the fields. But Teddy would always be his first friend and his best friend. And your special person will never find a better friend than you.